add value to the business. And I don't know any business who isn't demanding new solutions, new tools, and new applications on a daily basis. It's subscription, we all know that, which means we can move away from capital expense to operational expense and deployment issues. We've all implemented ERP, CRM, supply chain, 6, 12, 18, 24 months. I don't think I've ever seen a project like that be successful and the executive stakeholder was the same exec stakeholder at the beginning to the end. And things change. So if you think about the trends of technology, mainframe, client server, internet, and now the mobile internet, this took a long time, this took less time, this took less time, and all of a sudden now, the space and the acceleration of change is happening in a very, very short window. So again, Mary Meeker, I mentioned this last time, have a look at Mary Meeker's State of the Internet report about the pace of change across these different times of IT. And what we're saying is, don't lock yourself down to commoditized legacy client-server architectures that disable you, actually, to have business agility. You've got to be able to react to things very, very quickly. I'm going to talk about one thing here. Generally, what makes us different? We were born on the web. We don't have any legacy code base. We don't have, you know, 50 billion lines of ABAP code from SAP. We don't have, you know, massive estates of data centers with existing on-premise servers. We were born on the web. We operate at an enormous scale. We have hundreds and hundreds of millions of testers that enable us to make sure that things that we do, we get right first time. And actually, if you come to the bottom right, and this is what we're going to move on to, unless you operate at scale, it's really, really hard to get onto this kind of innovation cycle. People often come to us and say, look, this is what we're planning to do from an IT perspective, but here's the business challenges that I have. And we say, well, look, this is what we see as the business challenges, and here's our innovation roadmap. And we talk them through, look, what are those 218 things that we released last year? And by the way, here's another 250 things that we're going to be releasing this year. And they come to us because they want to partner with us. They want to become part of our innovation roadmap because we're really, really good at it. And despite moving IT resource to business logic, it's still pretty hard for people to try and think of the 250 things that are going to add value. So, our technology strategy investments for this year and moving forward for a couple of specifics, I'm going to focus at the bottom. Google Apps, we know about there's messaging, there's collaboration, there's security, there's compliance. We have a Google Apps marketplace where you plug in third-party ISVs into your Google Apps domain. It was 1 year old, actually, a couple of weeks ago. We now have 300 ISVs on that platform. And you can do it very, very seamlessly. You choose an app, you can type in CRM, you type in performance management. You choose it, you validate it, you stick it into the domain, and it's done. The authentication done seamlessly. So again, crushing down these deployment times. Google App Engine for Business is our platform as a service, where you develop web-based applications and you deploy that into your environment. This is a very, very big area. Forrester, ourselves, are championing this quite heavily. Then you get to some of the more interesting things, like Chrome. So the browser's gone from 40 to 120 million users in the last 13 months. Very, very heavily adopted. And then you get to Chrome OS and Android. And I've touched upon Android on the activations. But one of the questions we're often asked is, well, you know, BlackBerry and RIM, very, very well known for security features within enterprise. You know, where is Android honestly with enterprise? We're just starting to see the first early statistics now of Android adoption within the enterprise space. And given that Mary Meeker was wrong by 18 months about her Android consumer adoption, I would anticipate that this year is going to be very, very important. We have a new release of Android coming out, which is called Honeycomb, it's 3.0. One of the first things that is introducing is something called device encryption. Okay? We have to be very careful because you can get hardware degradation when you do device encryption. So trying to get that blend about providing enterprise-grade security but making sure that you as end users, as a consumer, and as an enterprise user, there should be absolutely no difference. But let me talk about Chrome OS, and that's really the main focus today. There's the now, and there's the go-to. So, Microsoft released 124 patches, security patches, last year. Worrying for a number of reasons, because it seems to be an ongoing trend. Patch Tuesday, we have actually App Tuesday, which is where we launch applications onto our marketplace. A little bit cheeky, but it was funny at the time. The problem, okay, with those patches is that you have to apply those to each of your client devices. It takes time, and it's extremely expensive to do. What is even worse is that the average taken to deploy those is between 30 to 60 days. So you have a vulnerability for that period of time on an awful lot of devices. This has been going on for years and years and years. And if you can't sort the issue at core, you continue to have a very big problem. It's also really expensive. The traditional enterprise desktop is very, very expensive to run. You know, Gartner quote $4,850. I don't know whether it's $3,000 or $5,000. It's pretty expensive. The software, the hardware, the change, support and maintenance of that. What is the actual loaded cost over 2 or 3 years? It's very, very expensive. Which brings me on to Chrome. So Chrome's been in development for quite a long time, probably 18 to 24 months in alpha. It's currently in late beta. We've got a beta machine which we're going to show you today. Look, why is Chrome important? Most importantly for us, there's two things that it underpins. The first one is speed. Okay, we are synonymous with speed. You go onto google.com, you type in your few queries, and you're going to get something sub-second, very, very, very quick. And that's the experience that we want to have across all of our products and applications. Cold boot, cold boot is 10 seconds. Standby is between 0.8 and 1.2. Now, I joked last time that my ThinkPad took 16 minutes, and it's getting worse. I've actually just put a request in to get rid of my ThinkPad, which is heartbreaking because I've been using the same machine for 14 years. But it's draining productivity for me in the morning. So speed is important because it drives productivity, but it also drives a hunger to use the device. Okay? So this device is going to be super, super quick. The second one, which is fundamental to why we're doing it, is around security. So 2 years ago, if I'd have said to all of you, for those of you that are worried about security in the cloud and Google, put your hand up. You would have probably all put your hand up. I think as partners with Microsoft and those other partners that are here today, the discussion around security has been diluted an awful lot because there are so many customers who've done their due diligence, their compliance security due diligence. Big, big brands are coming across software as a service, platform as a service, infrastructure as a service. But the key thing about security is we've actually gone to the root cause and said, okay, what is it that we can do to solve this ongoing nightmare of IT overhead around patching? So for us, Chrome OS is an operating system which is accessed via a browser, but the key difference is we actually see the browser as potentially being malicious. Okay? So we have something called a verified boot. When we're talking about thought leadership, this generally is a completely different way of doing things. I'm an end user, I log on, I'm working away. If I have tried to do something to that operating system, it will not boot. It will go back to the vanilla state. Or if I've had a virus trying to get onto the operating system, it will not boot. It will go back to the vanilla state as well. The US Army was one of our first trusted testers. We've got about 30 global brands at the moment going through advanced trusted tester. And some of these brands, like the US Army, they're not doing it because of applications. They're doing it for one thing only. They're doing it for security. Okay, so again, some of the other things that is provided, auto updates. The operating system auto updates when there is a new version. You don't have to do that yourself. There is no manual IT intervention. And from a management perspective, your administrator can choose which applications or which desktop extensions can be accessed. So I'm Thomas Davis. The administrator can choose that myself as a sales and marketeer can only have access to these applications and these extensions, and you can do that at a user base, a profile down to a single person. But more importantly, you can actually prohibit them. from using applications. So for the first time, you have a machine that boots fast, you have a machine that knows its core vanilla operating system, that can be controlled from a single unified web console and manage a multitude of different devices, including Chrome OS. So this year, between 2011 and 2012, it's estimated that Apple will ship approximately 50 million units of their iPad, V1 or V2. I'd love to come back in a year's time and talk to you about where we're seeing the advancement of Android and the advancement of this, because no one else does this. And we generally think it's going to change the IT landscape. And we hope in the next 2-3 months, you have an opportunity to have a look at it, review it, and hopefully give it some use. Thank you very much.